expecting when I'm building my house. That the reason you see, if someone is spending money to build a house, that person will come where the builders are doing the job, is going to check if everything is okay. Most of them, when they come, they say, I don't like this one this way, you can change this one. But the builder said, oh, you know, it's fine. It's fine. Why you don't like it? He said, no, that's not what I've got in my mind. I've got all of it in my picture. Amen. So you do the things according to the picture of God. And but I want to say that God had a plan for the redemption, to redeem back his children to his to himself. And that plan must be done in the way God wanted to be. God doesn't want someone to come and do something else. Amen. Mm-hmm. So the only one, the only person who has got the plan of God is the prophet. And God worked with the prophet all the ages to give them the word of God, to give them his word, for them to reveal the plan of God. Starting from Noah over there, even Abel, Joseph, all of them until William Branham came. All those people was talking about the plan of God. Do you know that the book, the Bible was written in so many parts? Do you know that? They just brought them together. Jeremiah wrote, and Isaiah somewhere, Hosea, all of them. So when they put all the books together, when they made them together, put them together, and all of them was in harmony. But I want to say that, the reason this Bible is perfect. Amen. The Bible was written by people by God's inspiration. God was telling them, write this, write this. Today we've got the Bible like this. But in that time it wasn't the Bible. It was just, how do you call it, the scroll. But the reason you see in the book of Isaiah, no, in the book of Luke, when Jesus got in the temple, he took the scroll, he didn't open the Bible, he took the scroll, he opened of the Isaiah. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And put it back there. You see? And when they took all those books, put them together, they made up, all of them line up. But I want to say that all the scriptures, from the beginning to the end, was speaking about the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. When you go in Genesis, the first thing you see there, the first sacrifice was, the lamb must be slain. Why? Because in God's mind, the lamb was there already. The Bible says that the lamb was slain in God's mind. Amen. Mm. So that plan of God must become in execution. And Abel took the revelation from the mind of God. God spoke to Abel by the revelation to go and to sacrifice the lamb. The Bible says, by faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain. So his sacrifice wasn't only good, but it was excellent. You see what I mean? If you can talk about colors, red, so if they show you red, say, oh, your answer is not good. Yellow is, okay, that's fine, you pass. Amen. When it's green, oh, you've done well. But when it's blue, excellent. Do you understand? Hmm. That's what we call the distinction in the school, yeah. In the universities. We say, oh, it's the distinction. And if you get the distinction, your work is excellent, they give you more, you get gifts, you know that. They give you maybe a bursary. They give you some money, some more money than others. Because you've done well, you're excellent. All of them, they are good. Some of them, green is okay. Yellow, you pass. Green, that's fantastic. But blue is excellent. And God, in this matter, it doesn't like yellow, green. God likes the excellent. Excellency. You must do exactly. But I want to say that when the Pharaoh came in the Garden of Eden, he said it's because they broke 0.99% of the word. Not even 1%. Less than 1. And all the world kept before. That's the reason why when I say that the word of God must be the word of God from the beginning to the end. Even if I don't understand it, I just say amen first, if by what I'm saying that. And then I'll understand it after. Amen. Because here is a matter of knowing what is in God's mind. You can be good, a good Christian, go to church every Sunday, singing songs, playing music, that's good, praying all the time. But as long as you don't have the mind of God, you still are a sinner. Amen.
Amen.
That is the reason I'm telling you, out of this message, there's no the word of God somewhere. The only way you found, because this message is God revealing himself to his people. Amen. In the time of Jesus, the only place to find God, it was in the church of Jesus Christ. Before Jesus Christ to come in the scene, the only place to find the word of God was with John the Baptist. And John the Baptist was alone to the desert, praying there, speaking to God. All the churches in the cities was singing, praying, but God wasn't there. Are you with me?
Amen.
God wasn't there. Because John the Baptist had the revelation that he's going to be the forerunner of this first coming of the Messiah. So God told him, you need to go to the desert to go and I'll speak to you over there. And John the Baptist, when he was standing there, seeing all those preachers preaching the word of God, he knew that they are wasting their time. God is not there.
Hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
And when he came out from the desert, all those people supposed to come and follow him, listen to what he was saying. And John the Baptist came, he said, you must repent yourself. Repent for what? We don't drink, we don't smoke. We are believers. Since Moses, since Abraham, our father, we are believers. So what kind of a message you are trying to preach us, telling us we have to repent? For what? Amen. They had to repent because it was the time of the changing. Amen.
Amen.
But I want to say that God is building not a wall, but God is building a house. Okay? Amen. When you go, when you're building a house, but I want to say that laying the wall like this is easy. Okay? But when you come down like this, you must make sure that you fix this one, this corner properly. Otherwise, your wall will go down. And for the corners, okay? For the corners, you need a specialist, someone who knows the job. Otherwise, you break everything. What people are doing today, just pray, but when we call it the dispensation, this one, the corner. Because they came from Egypt. God told them that you go to in the desert and build the tabernacle, and all the children of Israel, if you go in the book of Leviticus, you see, go and offer the sacrifice, bring the lamb as Abel did, and I will be, you'll be my children. Amen.
Mm.
And when John the Baptist came, he said, no, friends, you don't have to kill all the animals anymore because God had sent the perfect lamb. Okay. What? They don't want it. That's the reason John the Baptist said, repent. What was the repentance for? To change, the changing. Are you with me? The changing. So you don't have to give the sacrifice anymore like Abel did. It was good. The Bible says that by revelation, Abel gave the sacrifice to God, offered the sacrifice, the excellent sacrifice. What was the excellent sacrifice? It was the lamb, isn't it? But today, the lamb is not the excellent sacrifice anymore. Amen. You say, oh no, I'm going to do exactly what Abel did. No, I'm change. If I change, I'll make mistake. I'll just step on the elbow, do only what Abel did. Praise God.
I've got the revelation.
Because Abel, by making his sacrifice, God said, it's good, excellent. So let me make like Abel.
You come exactly like Abel, and God will reject it.
So why don't God's father? For Abel, you said excellent. But for me, why are you refusing?
He said, no, because it's another time.
Amen. Because this corner, John the Baptist was there in this corner to show the people that the time has changed. Before first, it was from the natural land of Egypt to the natural land of how do you call it?
Israel.
Not Israel.
The promised land.
Yeah, the promised land. To Canaan land. It was natural. So they had to walk like this. Going. Animals. Oh, they're getting out of Egypt. Oh, they're going. Okay? It was physical. And when they got in the land, now, but I want to say that it was not now the second step. Okay? From there, now they have to leave all those animals now to go to the baptism of the Holy Ghost. The second step. Mm-hmm. Said, no, you don't need to kill animals. You just lay yourself, lay hands upon the perfect sacrifice, which is Jesus Christ. Then you'll be forgiven from your sin. So, but I want to say that Jesus was trying to take them out of the physical matters to something which is spiritual. So today, you don't have to sacrifice the lamb. So if you have a lamb, it's good for the barbecue, isn't it? So make the barbecue, don't waste it. Amen. Mm. So Abel took his lamb, instead of him making his barbecue, he took it there to the altar. And if Abel took this lamb to make it a barbecue, God would be angry to him, isn't it? Because in that time, it was this lamb was needed. The requirement was, you must bring the physical lamb in that time. And you know that the prophet Elijah, he had two children, and those two children, what they were doing? When people was coming to the temple to sacrifice the lambs, they were taking the forks, the long one, and they take the meat and eat it. And God was unhappy about that. Amen. But today, if you see someone build a sacrifice like this, go take that meat, eat it. God will be happy with you. Listen. If you see my enemy taking a lamb, say, oh, my enemy, what are you doing? Say, oh, I'm going to burn a sacrifice for the Lord. Amen. Don't be afraid. Take your fork, take it and eat it. God will say, excellent. Because it's not a time anymore. Amen.
Amen.
Time has changed. The Bible says, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous. So Abel obtained the witness. Who was his witness? Who was Abel's witness? God himself. Amen. So you need God to testify you, not the people on the street. Amen. Because on the street someone can say, oh, you are a Christian. After tomorrow say, oh, you are a demon. It's not a true testimony. But the testimony of the true witness is the real testimony. Which, who is the true witness is God himself. Once God testifies about you, that's it. That's it. Amen. You see someone like Solomon. Solomon was a king. But at the end of his life, he started building the temple for idols. But God said, Solomon was saved. That's what the testimony. And so many people said, oh, see the way he finished his life. He's lost. He went to hell. But no. Someone like Saul. Saul was disobedient to the prophet, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And all the denomination churches, they said that Saul went to hell. But the Bible said, no, Saul went to heaven. Amen.
Amen.
God is the true witness. Let God to testify about you. Because here, God was testifying about Abel that he was righteous. Why? Because he produced exactly what was in God's mind. Amen. Mm-hmm. See it here. God testifying of his gift. God himself, not anybody else. It's not uncle or my father, my mother. No, I don't need them. The only witness I want to testify about me is the living God. When God saw it, say, oh, this is an excellent sacrifice. Thank you, Abel. Because Abel took what was in God's mind. And now you see the connection between Abel and Noah. What was connecting them? Noah done something else. Abel done something else. But one connection was between of them. Two of them, what they did? What was the connection? They've done just one thing in common. What was it?
Sacrifice.
Yeah. The will, they've done the will of God. You understand? They've done the will of God. That's the main thing. All of these people you see there in the Bible as heroes of faith, all of them, they've done the mind of God. They've done the will of God. That's what is going to make you hero. And it's what is going to push God to testify about you. If you are out of that, there's no way for you to be saved. Amen. Listen. And by it, being dead, yet speaketh. The Bible says that the blood of Abel still speaking. Amen. How the blood can speak? Is the blood speaks? No. But when I say that in the blood, there's life. And your life can speak. So after the death of Abel, he didn't die because the soul doesn't die. So it was speaking. And God told Cain, why don't you like your brother? And he didn't want to. Because the revelation of the word of God, no one is going to give it to you. You need to catch it yourself. Amen. Mm-hmm. So Abel was listening to God, God telling him what to do, and he went to represent it. Also, you must do the same thing. You hear God speaking to you, then do it. Amen. Mm-hmm. I'm not unable to give you the revelation. I can't do it. But Balaam said, even himself, even Balaam is not able to give you the revelation. God only gives revelation. Why? Because God gives you first his own life. Then you catch what he says. You understand? If someone never comes from God, there's no way for him to go back. Because redemption means to bring back. Some people on the street you see there, they never come from God. Amen. Mm-hmm. That's the reason Jesus told them that, John the Baptist said that you are the sons of the serpents, the sons of snakes. Say, our father is Abraham. Yes, physically, Abraham was their fathers. Yeah? Mm-hmm. But according to the seed of God, the seed which was the gem of life in them, it wasn't God's gem of life. It wasn't the seed of God. Yes, the child of Abraham, but we are not the child of God. Like Ishmael, he was the son of Abraham as well. Yes? Hmm. But it wasn't of royal seed. Because Jesus, God told Abraham, before to sacrifice the lamb, to offer the sacrifice, he told him that, Abraham, thank you because you didn't spare your only son. Your only son. Because God wasn't counting Ishmael. Amen. Hmm. And that one was representing the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Listen, the Bible, Romans chapter 10, verse 17. So then, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Amen. The word of God, what is that? The Bible, isn't it? But in that time, there wasn't a Bible. No, in time of Abel. No scroll, no nothing. But he had the revelation. So now ask me, how Abel got the revelation from God? Because he came from God. His spirit came from God because he was the son of God, the son of Adam. Do you understand? And Cain wasn't the son of Adam. That's the reason he didn't get the revelation. Even God came to Cain to tell him, oh, why you don't like your brother? He refused. Amen. Because it wasn't found in God to begin with. The revelation is only to the children of God. So never mind. Don't expect everybody to believe the message. No. The only one who's going to believe the message is the only people who was in God before to come in flesh. Because this message is bringing people back to God. It's not taking people to God, it's bringing back. Amen? Amen. If we start talking about Congo here, you never maybe understand what I'm talking about. But some people here don't understand. Oh, because I came from there. Amen. And when I start talking about Congo, for you guys, it's going to be boring. Oh, what are you talking about? Oh, come on. You're bored. But when you're talking with my brothers, you know how, when we were small, we used to play like this and that. Cook fake food and eat it here. You just laugh, but you don't. But my brothers knows exactly what I'm talking about. Listen to my brothers.
Yes.
Because he and me, we used to be there. It's exactly the same as heaven. Before you go to heaven, you must come from heaven. I'm not going to heaven, I'm going back to heaven. Amen. So many people today say, one day Jesus will take us and go to the rapture. No. He's not going, he's going back. And since the first step here, the physical matters finish. And there it was the spiritual matters. From the Judaism to the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Spiritual. That's not physical thing. And we're going to say that all the promises of God are spiritual. And because spiritual, the spirit is greater than the flesh.
Hmm.
Amen. But when I say that Jesus, when he came down, he took the lowest form, which is the flesh. Even you, but when I say that even you and me, the lowest form we go is the flesh. Because you are God inside of you.
Hmm.
This flesh is not you. So, since that time, all the physical promises finish. Everything is spiritual. That's the reason the people didn't understand Baba Bama. But when I say like, oh, the same messenger will go to the rapture with his goal. And Baba Bama died. So the people were sad. What happened? Amen.
Mm-hmm.
He was raptured before he died. Are you with me?
Mm-hmm.
And then, it was the same with Jesus. When Jesus died, Peter was so sad. They went to the grave. And I think Mary told them, oh, he's risen from the dead. Peter said, oh, what is that? Yes, I saw him. Then, don't believe it. Listen, Peter was the friend of Jesus, isn't he? Peter was always beside Jesus. Always. And Jesus told him that, Peter, after 3 days, I'll be raised up from the dead. Maybe they said amen. But they didn't believe it. Amen. You can't be in the church preaching, say amen, but you don't believe. And Peter didn't believe it. And when the time came, Peter said, I don't believe it. Until they took Peter to the grave, he saw the empty tomb, then he said, that's not believing, that's not faith. You see? So faith coming from by hearing, the hearing by the word of God. The word of God, what is that? The word of God is the Logos, as I told you. The Logos. The Bible is a scripture. They took the Logos in written form. But the word of God is this one. So if you are not part of this, you never understand the word of God. The Logos, the good light. In the beginning was the word, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. You understand? But the Bible says that, the Bible says that by the word God created the world. He couldn't create anything without the word of God, the word. So he had to create the word first. But the Bible says that what is that? He said that is the fullness of God's attribute. All God was inside of the pit of fire. When he got there, but the Bible says that he was trying to empty the space to start creating. This one is deep for you, isn't it? So God, the word of God, began to create. And he created the world and the universe. Amen. So when God was creating, Job said, God spoke to Job, he asked him, where were you when I was laying the foundation of the world? When the morning stars, the children of God were singing with joy. Even before the beginning, you and me, we were there singing. When God was laying the foundation of the world, I was singing. What kind of song? I don't know. Amen. I wasn't there in this flesh, but I was there. Are you with me? So don't be like others. You are special. Special people. But I'm saying this in a message called Marriage and Divorce. He said, Abel built the same kind of an altar. But when Abel bought he bought a lamb. Now, Cain thought that making an antidote for sin, that his father and mother must have eat fruit, as they were thought in that garden. Amen. This one is deep. But Abel, by divine revelation, yes, knew that it was the blood that did it. Amen. By divine revelation, okay? And the Bible said in Revelation, offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which God testified that he was righteous. Is that right? The congregation said, Amen. Amen, brother, sister. It's just as plain as anything can be to me. There is one thing. His sacrifice was more excellent. The Bible says that. And Abel, he also bought of the firstlings of his flock, and of the fat thereof, and the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering. Why? Because the lamb has been slain before the foundation of the world. Okay. Before the foundation of the world, in God's mind, that was the lamb was slain. And Abel was trying to represent what was already in God's mind. And when God saw it, God said, I like it. God said, Amen on that. You understand? So today, the mind of God came through the prophet of God. And faith is to have the revelation. As I said, faith means revelation. Do you know that? Faith means revelation. How do you have faith? But I want to say that faith is like a purchase power. Okay? I gave you an example before. Purchase power, you've got something, you've got some money in your pocket. Say, oh, I'm going to buy a loaf of bread. But what he said that as long as you've got money in your pocket, that means you've got the loaf of bread, isn't it? Yeah. You don't have the loaf of bread, but the money is the purchase power. So you don't have any doubt that you're not going to eat the bread. You know that the bread is there. If they tell you, okay, show me the bread, you show money. So that's not the bread, say, yeah, but it's the purchase power. That's the faith. Yeah. You understand? But I want to say that faith is not hope. Faith is a substance, something you know that you've got it. The revelation. That's the meaning of the revelation. But I'm saying that most of people, when they're coming to the prayer line, they don't have faith, they've got the hope. But I'm saying that if you've got faith, you don't have to come to the prayer line. You just stay there, you're healed. So many people are getting healed in the congregation, isn't it? Now, when Abel gave his sacrifice, God accepted. But when Cain gave the sacrifice, it was rejected. Because this sacrifice here was representing Jesus on the cross. Do you understand? But I want to say that God had this plan of redemption already. Do you understand? He said, because before to create God was Elohim. I spoke about it before. Do you know that? God became God. Before to become God, he was Elohim. Do you understand? There wasn't anybody to worship him. Because God means the object of worship. And when he created angels and Adam and Eve, when they began to worship him, then he became God. Do you understand? But in his mind, he had already the plan to make this to be for him to be the father. You can't be a father if you don't have children, isn't it? He wants to be a father, but to be a father, he must go through this one. He had all this plan. Abel had the plan of God, but him, Cain, didn't have any plan of God. He was going to church, yes, but no plan of God. That's what we call Sister Rebecca. He was a church member. If you don't have God's plan, you are just a church member. And God doesn't know anything about you. Amen. But if you've got God's plan, now God knows about you. Because in this church here, you see these two people. But in God's eyes, it's only one person there. Amen. What you say, oh, when my God could accept this one and refuse this one? Why? God is not fair, isn't it? Is God unfair? God is fair enough. He had to represent first what was in God's mind. Amen. Mm-hmm. If he died exactly the same as this one, God could accept it, isn't it? Mm-hmm. But he refused. Why did he refuse? Because he wasn't a child of God to begin with. Close. But why don't you check this? And he said, the devil always walks in the beauty. Sure, he does. That's the reason Cain offered what he did for his offering. But there was no beauty in Abel bringing his lamb. Amen? Mm-hmm. But Abel had a spiritual revelation from God. That's what God would be pleased with. It's not only going to church just praying. Keep praying. You know, as I said, sometimes when you pray, even you pray for someone who's sick, try to find first the will of God. Because one day, my father was going to Germany to pray for someone, for a boy. God said, don't go there, it's my heart. Sometimes you can pray for someone and you go against God. Amen. As we have said, only through spiritual revelation can you ever know God. Amen. You'll never know him by knowledge. Because you've been studying the Bible a lot. You know all Bible verses. You know all the message books. And then you go know God. No. God has to reveal it to you. Because if knowing God is only reading books, even the poor will be a child of God. If it's said it, it does read the Bible. Amen. Satan reads the Bible and knows the Bible better than so many believers. Do you know that? Yeah. But he's not a child of God. When Cain and Abel was in the Garden of Eden, to begin with, Cain was just as religious as Abel was. But what taught Abel, it took a lamb. What taught Cain, it took a nice something to catch the eye of God. And Cain worshiped just the same as Abel worshiped. Cain made an offering the same as Abel did. Cain was just as sincere as Abel was. So, sincerity don't save you. Amen? Mm-hmm. God has a way, a program. You got to walk into that. Are you with me? God has got his plan and his program. You have to walk according to God's program. But when I said that Abel made a sacrifice, Cain also offered a sacrifice. Cain worshipped. Abel also worshipped. Both of them, isn't it? And Cain didn't worship Satan. He was worshipping Jehovah, the living God. The same God as Abel was worshipping too. Amen. But Cain wasn't in God's program. He was out of that. And this one made him a church member. Amen. Amen. But Abel was in God's program, and God agreed the sacrifice of Abel. And he was testified as a righteous because he knew God's mind and God's program. Amen. So today, the program of God has come. From Malachi 4, but Abraham, he came to teach us about the plan of redemption. He told us everything, but Abraham, before he left the sin. And when he left the sin, everything was fulfilled. Because Jesus, before he left the earth, he said, everything is fulfilled. And God will never, ever take his messenger or his prophet without finishing the job. God had to finish first before to take Balaam out of the sea. So when you see Balaam out of the sea, that means all the plan of God has been given to you. The only thing you have to do is to study it, to know it. Amen. So many people, even in the message, going to the churches, they are doing exactly like Cain. They don't mind the plan of God. You give them the plan of God, they say, oh, we don't want it. You need to win this. Oh, no. That's fine. I believe. I go to the mountain 3 days, keep praying. That's not God. You're wasting your time. Seek first God's plan. You can go to the mountain. Who told you to go to the mountain? If God didn't tell you to do that, God is not happy with that. God likes only what is his will. First of all, seek first the kingdom of God. Amen. What is the kingdom of God? It's God himself and his program. Amen. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. You have any question? Feeling much better? Do you have any question? Yes, it's America. Oh, the square. That square was only the explanation. I was trying to explain that. If you are building a house, yeah? When you come here, before to start this line here, two of them, they must join there, isn't it? But when they join there, you need someone who knows better the job to do it, otherwise the house is going to collapse. Because they must go like this. If you don't do it properly, because if this is the wall, you take another wall, you put it here, you know what's going to happen? This one's going to fall down, this one's going to fall down as well. But if you do them like this, they become one. So to do the job here on the corner, you need someone who's specialist. And it's the same as the word of God. When they started, it was the Judaism, okay? Burning sacrifices. And God sent John the Baptist here to tell them that you have to stop this one because we are going to start this one. A special man is the prophet. So he came to teach them that you have to leave this kind of sacrifice, come to this one. Okay? And when after him also, in this time also, Barabbanah, God sent Barabbanah. And Barabbanah told us all the plans of God. He said, okay, this one is okay. But now, God doesn't require this one anymore. So from this, go to this one. And so many people today, they missed this corner here. The building of the corner, when you miss it, your house is not going to stand. It's going to collapse. Amen? Is it clear? So we call it dispensation. God works like that. goes from there to there. Amen.